Okay, so in this video we're going to look at making a simple maze style game. Really the point is to show you how to texture an environment like this using selected faces. So we'll make the model, we'll select some faces, and then we apply a texture or different textures to those different faces. It's so that we can have floors that are a different texture to the ceiling and so on. Okay, delete that. I'll go add mesh plane. I'll just press S and drag that to about the size of the grid and change the view, so down to view to top like this. And next what I'm going to do is go into edit mode like that and choose subdivide here. Click that and you can see that it's taken the one face and made it into four. Then every time we press it, each of these faces gets divided into four until we've got a good few to play with there. So I'm going to go with that. You can see how many faces in total we've got here. The more faces you've got, the more detailed you can make it. So at the moment, all the faces are selected. I'm going to press the A key to deselect them all, because obviously we need to select the areas that are going to be our walls. A couple of ways to select. Right click on a face. Oh, let's just change it to face mode down here. So face select, right click, hold shift and click any others that you want. But obviously that's a bit tedious. We might want to select larger areas. So I'm going to press B and this allows us to what's called box select. So I can click and drag over a good bunch at a time. I'll do it again. Okay, and something like that. This is going to be the exit here. We're going to start around here. So now I'm just going to make some interior walls. I'm not going to make my maze terribly complicated. I'll leave that to you. But you can see I'm just pressing B and then dragging. Moving it across some these two, make the maze, or in my case, a path. Now if I hold shift and right click on some of these, I can actually, you know, take away some of my selection, so I've made it marginally more complicated there. And yeah, okay, that will do. So we can see a clear path through the maze there. And I'm now going to, I'll tell you what, just because I feel the need to, oopsie-daisy, I've just made a mistake. So Command and Z or Control and Z. There we are. Marginally more complicated. Anyway. So I've got all my faces selected, and if I just press the scroll wheel down so I can get into a perspective view, I'm going to press E and up we go. Push the mouse forward and that will make our walls. Dead simple. Okay. I'm going to save that. And now we'll look at the texturing. Now, we want to texture the floors differently to the walls. So I've already been on the internet and I've got myself some textures, and I hope by now that you've done the same thing. It's a bit tedious again just to hold shift and click on all of these. So fortunately, we can hold alt and click on one of them and it selects every face that is perpendicular to it, which is very handy. So it loops right the way around like that, and you can see that we've got all of the walls in there. Now, to make the texture appear correctly, we're going to need to unwrap this mesh. So we'll come down here on the left hand side and look for unwrap. Okay, UV mapping unwrap, and I'm going to choose a cube projection because it's essentially a cube. And then we're ready to apply our texture. I'm just going to drag this out a little bit so I can see what's going on a little bit better. And here I'm going to click on the materials tab, and I'm going to go with new, and I'm going to call this walls. And then over here on the button next to it, make a new material, and I'm going to, instead of clouds, I'm going to make it an image or a movie. And I'm going to open. Excuse me. Look at my documents there. Wrong folder. There we are, textures. So I've organised my textures that I'm using here. So I've got one in stone that I want to use for the walls, this limestone small bricks. You'll of course have your own image. Open image. And at the moment, we can see that we're in Blender Render. So ideally, because obviously we're making a game, we'd go to Blender Game. And for that as well, we just better change it in the render panel here, GLSL. And also, so we can see what's going on a bit better, here we can change our viewport shading to texture. And there we go, all of a sudden that makes a big difference. So you can see the texture that we selected there, but it's not looking quite right. So over here again in the texture panel, and scroll down until we get to here, the coordinates, and hopefully if I press UV, okay, that's put them the right way around at least. Looking quite large though, so I'm going to scale these. So here in the size area, I'm going to go with about 3. See what that looks like. And if you look a little bit closer there, you can see that it's applied that texture quite neatly to those walls. Okay, good. And now for the floors. Well, what we'll do is we'll click assign. There we go. So that assigns that material there. Okay, now to get the floor, it is going to be a little bit more complicated. So I'm going to change the view to top. And just click view persp ortho like that. There we go. And if it helps, if you change it to wireframe, you might be able to in edit mode. You might be able to see what's going on a little bit more. If not, I'll go back to texture. We can just about see what's going on there. So again, I'll press B. I'm going to click and drag over. I don't need to sort of encompass. Basically, if I drag this box, any that I touch with my selection becomes selected. So any that I drag over, you'll see, even if I just go over ever so slightly, helps if you press B, ever so slightly, there we go. So I don't need to do some sort of big selection thing. And if you do go wrong, so if, for example, you get too much like that, oops-a-daisy, Command and Z or Control and Z. So I just carry on doing that, making my selections. So just getting the floor. There we go. And now, over here, I'm not going to worry about this top bit here because we're going to just put a plane on top for our roof. I'm going to make a new material. Add a new material. And new. And this one is going to be floor. Okay, and again, click on the texture here. And scroll up if you need to. And click on new. And again, I've got an image for this. So instead of clouds, we'll choose image or movie. And open. And this one it's the limestone floor. Make an image, and hopefully, and here I'll go with floor image. Okay. And if we have a little look at that, and then go back perhaps to our material and choose assign. Now we can see it in the viewport as well. Again, quite large, so to change that, we can go back to the image, the material. Sorry, not the material, the texture. And down here, I'm going to put that at 3 as well, see what that looks like. Still a bit big. Try 5. Okay, that'll do. So there we go. We've now textured our environment. Like I say, if you want to put a roof on it, add mesh plane. Maybe easier in the top view. Oops. Put that in the middle. Press S to make that a bit bigger. And lift that up. So it's just about at the top. Don't want any gaps. So we can see that we might be able to, you know, use that. And you can just add a material to that of your own choosing. Okay. So that's how to add textures to different faces of the same object.